the links between the microbiome and autoimmune diseases must go through sex. We know that autoimmune diseases are largely female predominant, with a very few exceptions. But still, we have no idea what the mechanisms for these differences are. So one option is obviously related to sex hormones. We know that during a woman's life, there's different degrees of estrogens, and then once she gets into menopause, this drops. And that's the moment in which, for most conditions, she's at the highest risk of developing the disease. On the other hand, we do know that men and women are different from the standpoint of the gut microbiome, with several species being found most commonly in one of the two sexes. How to put these pieces of the puzzle together remains quite unknown. We have been reviewing at this meeting some evidence in which we show, for example, that for conditions that affect experimental models differently, depending on sex, we do know, for example, that transferring the fecal sample will also transfer the susceptibility or the protection to this disease. On the other hand, we do know that, for example, exposure in early life to antibiotics will change the incidence of type 1 diabetes, again in experimental models, but in a different way, whether it's male or female mice we're talking about. Ultimately, we know that, for example, beta-2 estradiol, which is probably the major estrogen hormone, has an impact on the microbiome of patients and models of multiple sclerosis. How to put all this data together remains quite complicated, quite puzzling, I would say. I think that we need to add another factor into the equation that we're trying to solve. We know that the immune system is affected by the microbiome. We clearly know that autoimmune diseases are based on an immune system derangement. Whether there's also a shortcut between the microbiome and autoimmunity that is translated into whether the microbiome contributes to breaking down the immune tolerance that eventually leads to the autoimmune disease remains a major open question for the future. I encourage all researchers and clinicians involved, respectively, in the microbiome and in autoimmune disease to join forces to address this crucial question, which will have important development in the future.